In this video, I'm going to show you how to take one of our GH15 contactors and the appropriate overload and connect them up together into one unit like this one. Now, when you purchase the overloaded contactor, there is in-box documentation, and you can also find that same documentation and more on our website. But if you're like me, you want to see a video how to connect these up. So that's what we're going to show you today. When you purchase an overload, you'll get two bags full of accessories with these mounting brackets, bolts, nuts, washers, and some screws. That's what I'm going to show you how to connect up. In order to assemble the overload to the contactor, you're going to need a flathead screwdriver and a ratchet or wrench or both in order to tighten up the nuts and bolts. First, we want to slide in the included bus bars. Now, if you look at these closely, two of them have offsets and all of them have a tapped hole. These you want to go through the bottom of the overload, and the offsets need to go on the outsides furthest. Once I have all of these in, you can connect them up with the included screws into these holes. Now the first two sets we can get in fine. The last one, the auxiliary contact, is in the way. So we simply just loosen it, disconnect it, move it out of the way, and we can insert our last screw to tighten down all of these bus bars. Now, connect our auxiliary contact back. Next, we'll want to attach our overload to the contactor itself. Now, you might be thinking we could do this just directly by bolting it. Well, they're offset for a reason. Had we put these bars in the reverse side through the top, yes, they do match up, but you don't want your overload up here off of your panel. You want to use these offsets so your overload and your contactor are both flush on the same mounting surface. So here, we'll install all of the bolts, washers, lock washers, and nuts to the contactor and the overload. Now, if you notice, we're using a bolt, flat washer, and on the bottom side, we're using a lock washer and the nut. So now I have my overload and my contactor both bolted together. Now I only hand tighten these bolts and nuts just for demonstration purposes. So make sure you use some wrenches and ratchets and tighten these up good. Now I can show you it is one unit. And if you notice, they're both on the same plane so you can mount them to your sub panel in your enclosure. And a little word of advice, don't forget to tie your control circuits into the overload. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you again soon.